Hello and welcome in this transition tutorial where I want to teach you how to make such an animation in After Effects. Without any further ado, let's head right into it. I will create a new composition, HD 30 frames 5 seconds. I will call this composition Masky, like that, and I'll select OK. Now I'll go to the rectangle tool, I'll select the rectangle tool and I'll double click on it. This will create a new shape layer with a rectangle inside of it, and it will cover the entire screen. Let's maybe select another color this time, maybe something beige, like yellowish, bright, something like that, something pleasant for the eye. Let's hit OK, and we have our rectangle prepared. Now I want to show you how to work with masks. When you are selecting the rectangle tool, or by holding selecting another tool, like the ellipse tool that we'll use now, you have a selection. To create a new shape, if I do this, this will create a new ellipse, a new content shape, or you can click this to create a mask, and a mask reveals just a selected portion of the shape layer we have. Of course, we can change those options, we can invert those options, but basically a mask does exactly that. I want to create two masks here. I will stay with the ellipse tool, I'll hold my shift key, and I create a big ellipse around it. I want this to be really big above the screen. I see this mask should be shifted, so I press V and I shift the mask so it covers the screen. Having the mask here, I click on it and I duplicate it because I want to have two masks. I'll change the color of the mask just so it's easier for me to edit and see which mask I'm selecting right now. And now comes the entire beauty. Please select the mask and we have the mask path. And this is the only thing we will be editing today. At first, I want to go with this mask. And I place a keyframe here. Maybe I place the keyframe forward to 20 frames forward. Let's go to 20 frames and this keyframe will be here. But at the beginning, I want this mask to look completely different. So by having my selection tool selected, I double click on it and I make it smaller. I place it in the middle. I go here on the right bottom side. I make it smaller and remember that this keyframe is holding all the informations about it. As I go back to this keyframe, it will go back to the initial point, but I want to edit this keyframe. On this keyframe, this little object should be invisible. It's hard to click, but let me double click. Okay, I've selected it. I want it to be on the right corner, and I want it to be basically invisible. I select my left shift key, my left control key, and I make it barely visible. I do the same for this object. I open up the mask number 2, I go here, I click on a keyframe, I go to my first frame, and I do the same. By having the move tool selected, I double click on it, I make it smaller, I place it in the left corner this time, and you see already something is happening. Don't worry about that, we need to position it properly. Here, this should be even less visible, so let me correct that, okay? Of course, I selected now the wrong item. Double click, okay. Double click. I got it. And I make it invisible. Like this, okay. Now it's kinda invisible. Now, this could be already our finished animation. Let me preview this. But maybe those rounded circles are a bit boring. They are cool because normally you would have to select this mask and you would have to change its size another keyframe. Change its position, another keyframe. And here we have everything on one simple keyframe. What you can play around and change with it, you can invert the selection. This will create a completely different animation, like this, boom, boom. You can, for example, intersect. I'll stay with intersect, and instead of spreading like this, they'll intersect each other. Let me click on the mask. Until they don't touch itself, nothing is visible, and we have completely different animations just by clicking one button. You see how this works? So you have much freedom and you have a really interesting animation with those options. This is basically what you can achieve. You can simply duplicate it, go forward, silhouette alpha on this one, and you have a perfectly prepared transition in a matter of seconds. You can then play around with the keyframes, select all layers, press U on your keyboard, right click, Keyframe Assistant Easy Ease. Now the motion will be a bit different. If you want it to spread quicker, select those keyframes and bring them closer. Boom and boom. Yeah, I think those quick ones look really interesting. Boom and boom. Okay, this is how you make a transition with help of masks and their pads.